بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد. الحمد لله بالكثير على حلقة في السيرة ممتازة يوجد الحمد لله تبدأ بميشة فان أبابير عمران إخوان خاصة من أبابير أبو الجماعة عصر because the pattern of the message is that when we have the جماعة then they are given the number one priority to host the programs and to do the حلقات. And الحمد لله it's a great honor to have the جماعة in the message. It's a great blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we see our brothers, mashallah, every now and then that they come and moves and shake us that and help us realize that what is the maqsad of us in this dunya, in this world. Alhamdulillah, today we'll take an exception, took the permission from the Amir, inshallah. We'll continue with halaqa of Sirah, inshallah, and I will try to make it short, inshallah. As all of you have noticed that we were in the first era of Islam, in the very beginning era of Islam, in which we learned that we are learning that the Sahaba, radiallahu alayhim ajma'in, when they embraced Islam and how many difficulties came on their ways and how many hardships came on their way, and they stood their ground. They did not leave the iman. Or they did not compromise anything, even a little, in their iman, in their beliefs in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the reason, the maqsad of learning about these sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in, it is to look up to them. Because many times when we come to a difficulty, and if we don't have the picture of someone in our mind, then we lose confidence in ourselves. You know, we hear from the sisters, unfortunately, that, you know, what's the ruling of hijab? Because friends make fun of us. And we ourselves, that when we used to go to university, that we would feel shy to wear our jubba or to put our, topi on, because we could not hold the pressure of the society. But if we were learn, and if you were to see in the seer of the Sahaba, in the seer of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then it will give us confidence. It will give us this yaqeen that this, making fun of people is nothing. The Sahaba went to much more difficulty and much more harder time. So alhamdulillah, last week we studied about Khabbab ibn al-Arad radiallahu anhu and how how many hardships he went through, and then before that we learned about Bilal radiallahu anhu and Hamza radiallahu anhu, and it was a great boost of iman for us, alhamdulillah. Today inshallah we will learn about Ammar bin Yasir radiallahu anhu, one of the great sahabi of Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his father Yasir radiallahu anhu, and his mother Sumayya radiallahu anha. In fact, ulama have said, the mu'allikheen have said, that this is the first family as a whole who accepted Islam. Ammar radiallahu anhu, when he was informed about the tawheed, about the concept of tawheed by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he took the da'wah to his mother, who was very old. Sumayya radiallahu anha was very old. The mu'allikheen have said that maybe in her late 90s. But when she heard the da'wah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by his son Ammar radiallahu anhu, she accepted Islam right away. Alhamdulillah. And then he took the da'wah to his father Yasir radiallahu anhu. Later on he accepted Islam also. But remember, this family, Yasir radiallahu anhu, the father of Ammar radiallahu anhu, he did not belong to a very high class family of Quraysh. Rather, he came. In fact, the Mu'allikheen have said that Yasir radiallahu anhu, the way he entered in Mecca was that he came. You know, he had one of his brother that was lost. That got lost. So he looked. You know, he was looking for him in every tribe, and he ended up in Mecca, and he was looking for his brother. He could not find him, and then he just stayed there. He belongs to a tribe Qahtani. قحطان. Then he became a friend with Abu Huzaifa Makhzumi, who was a nice-hearted person in Mecca, and who said that you can stay in Mecca. But anyhow, he did not, you know, Yasir radiallahu anhu did not belong to a high class of Quraysh. So he would do little work here and there. You know, he was a hand-labor kind of person. And Huzaifa, Abu Huzaifa Makhzumi later on, he gave him the offer, or he gave him as a gift, one of his slave girls, Sumayya radiallahu anha, to marry. And then Sumayya radiallahu anha, she was an Ethiopian slave. She came from Ethiopia, she was slave of Abu Huzaifa al-Makhzumi, Sumayya radiallahu anha, she was married to Yasir radiallahu anhu. And then Yasir radiallahu anhu had few sons from one of them, Ammar and Abdullah ibn Yasir radiallahu anhu. But anyhow, when Ammar radiallahu anhu, when he declared his Islam, remember in the beginning era of Islam, it was really difficult for the Sahaba to openly declare the Islam, to say to the Kuffar that we are Muslims, because Kuffar were looking for those who would give testimony of the Islam and would give them hardship and would beat them. The Mawlikhin have clearly said that they would not only put their hands on two people, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, because they were from the high class, but they had a very strong family background. The tribe was very strong. In fact, Abu Jahl and other Kuffar, they still used to give hardship to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, but not openly. But when they would find someone who is weak and has accepted Islam, they would go openly and would torture them, would beat them, to lay them down on the on the ground. In fact, Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he mentioned in his book Al-Bidayah wa Nihayah that the same torture was done to Ammar and to his parents. All three of them, that they would the kuffar would go to their house, even though they were not slaves. All they belong to a very low class, to Kuffar, the higher class of Kuffar, Kuffar of Mecca, the Quraysh, the leaders of Quraysh, would get their hands on them and would drag them out of their house and would make them wear the chain armor and would lay them on the heat of Mecca, and would constantly ask them that whether you give up Islam or you were going to give your life. To the extent that ulama have, the Mawlikhin have mentioned, that the mother of Ammar bin Yasir radiallahu anhu, Sumayya radiallahu anha, Abu Jahl, la'natullahi alayhi, may Allah's curse be upon him, one day he became really upset with Sumayya radiallahu anha. He went to her and he offered her that whether today you give up on Islam or you would give up on your life. And Sumayya radiallahu anha, the Mu'arikhin have said that she was at that time 100 years old. She was a very old woman, 100 years old. She said, with full confidence that I would not give up on my Islam, I would rather give up on my life. So Abu Jahl, he ordered his slaves, he ordered them to bring the two most healthiest camel that he had with him, Abu Jahl. And he ordered his slaves to tie one of the leg of Sumayya radiallahu anha with one camel and the other leg with the other camel. And he made them run he made both of the camels to run on the opposite directions. Not only that, but the Mu'arikhin said that his operation did not stop there, but rather when they were stretching her body, he threw a spear. In one narration it says that he threw the spear in the stomach of Sumayya radiallahu anha. And in one narration, it said that it threw the spear on the private parts of Sumayya radiallahu anha to chop her off into two pieces. Yet Sumayya radiallahu anha did not compromise on her Islam, on the concept of Tawheed, that Allah is one and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the true messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Mu'arikhin have said that Sumayya radiallahu anha gave the best example of sabr, of self-sacrifice. It is easy for us many times that we give the targhib, we motivate people to give sacrifice, but when it comes to sacrifice upon us, then we are unfortunately very behind. we make ta'wil, you know, we say that, you know, inshallah when we do this, that will happen, later on this will happen, and it is the fault of our leaders and this and that. When it comes to self-sacrifice, we are unfortunately very bad. Yeah. And the third example that she left behind was self-control. That this woman, it is narrated in one of the narration in the hadith that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to walk by Ammar bin Yasir and his father Yasir and Sumayya radiallahu anha at the time of their torture, and would humble them by saying that, Ya Ala Yasir, that all the family of Yasir, hold on to your Islam. And these Sahaba would not even complain to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that Nabi of Allah make dua against the kuffar. They would just become sabr. They would become, you know, patience. And then in one of the narrations, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that there are three people upon whom Jannah looks forward to meet them. There are three people upon whom Jannah is excited to meet them. One of them, Ali radiallahu anhu, and one of them is Salman al-Farsi radiallahu anhu, and one of them, Ammar bin Yasir radiallahu anhu. And in one of the narration to show the status of Ammar radiallahu anhu, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the hadith is narrated by Ali radiallahu anhu, he says to the Sahaba clearly that after I pass away, follow the guidance of Umar, of Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhu, and follow the sacrifices of Ammar radiallahu anhu, and follow the statements, the fiqh of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, and you will be guided. You will be guided. This is how great Ammar radiallahu anhu was. In fact, in one of the narration, Ali radiallahu anhu, he said that I give testimony that I have heard with my own ears, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying regarding Ammar radiallahu anhu, that Ammar radiallahu anhu is the person who is filled with iman from the top of his head till the bottom of his feet. He's filled with iman. And shaitan could not come near to Ammar radiallahu anhu due to the fact that he has from iman. You know, the sacrifice of the sahaba are such that, you know, and Ammar radiallahu anhu, about him also, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in one of the hadith, when he was mentioning the fada'il, the virtue of Ammar radiallahu anhu, that man aada Ammar, aada Allah. وَمَنْ أَبْغَضَ عَمَّارَ أَبْغَضَهُ اللَّهُ. That whoever becomes enemy with Ammar, Allah is enemy against him. And whoever keeps bughus and hard feelings with jealousy against Ammar, Allah has bughus against him also. So whoever declares war against Ammar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly declares war against that person. This is how great the Sahaba. So we learned from the stories, the moral of the stories. And in fact, the ulama have said that Sumayya radiallahu anha, when she was martyred, she became the first shaheed of Islam. She became the first woman who died, you know, the first person who died for Islam was Sumayya radiallahu anha, the first shaheed of Islam. And his father later on also, Yasir radiallahu anhu, when he was tortured by Kuffar, he also gave up his life, he also died. But he did not die while they were torturing him, but he died afterwards. But Yasir radiallahu anhu also left or also gave up his life, sacrificing for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Yasir radiallahu anhu, or Ammar bin Yasir radiallahu anhu, he passed away when he was 93 in the Battle of Siffin. In the Battle of Siffin. He was a great mujahid. In fact, ulama have said that he was one of the one who participated in most of the ghazwat and most of the saraya by Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the moral of the story that we take from today is that no matter what comes on our way, especially at times that we are living in, you know, people will always attack you, you know, when you wear the topi, when you wear the tubab, when even you covered your ankles, or you know, when you uncovered your ankles, people will make fun of you. What we have to do from our side, we should not look down upon our deen. Be always confident, because the sunnah has power in it. The sunnah has benefits in it. No matter what comes out, you know, on our way, we should not look down, you know, upon ourselves and upon our deen. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with. There are the Sahaba on the other side who gave major sacrifices. Our sacrifices have nothing towards it. In fact, when people even laugh at us, you know, we make a big issue on their backs, you know, start backbiting them or start slandering. You know, it's a big thing to us. Everything is a big issue to us. You know, for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, little things, when people do, we would go even harsh on their ways. You know? This is not the tariqah, this is not the way of the Sahaba. In fact, the Sahaba were the one who is steadfast on the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is steadfast on their ground, and they were till the last of their death from Muslims. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave testimony regarding the Sahaba that radiallahu anhum wa radu'an. That they are pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also pleased with them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq to learn from the story of the Sahaba and help us to revise our iman like the Sahaba, and help us to stand on our ground when the challenges come. When we make God Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us, number one, from the challenges, from the difficulties, from the hardship. But if they come on their way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to not lose our ground and not lose the hope in Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ameen. Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma adkhilna innaka antas samii'ul 'aliim wa tub 'alaina innaka antat tawwabur rahiim. اللهم انا نسالك من الخير كله عاجله واجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم، ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله واجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم. سبحان ربك رب العزه عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاك الله خير.